اهلا بكم. My talk today will be about the nutcracker syndrome and the superior mesenteric artery syndrome. In normal anatomy, the angle between the aorta and the superior mesenteric artery is ranging from 25 degree to 60 degree. This angle is preserved by the presence of the mesenteric fat, as you see in this image. This is the aorta here, this is the superior mesenteric artery, and this is the mesenteric fat, and here we have two structures passing in this angle. The left renal vein and the duodenum. This is the third part of the duodenum. Any condition resulting in decrease of this mesenteric fat, it will consequently decrease this angle. Decrease of the angle less than 22 degrees, it will result in compression of either the left renal vein or compression of the third part of the duodenum or compression of both of them. Compression of the left renal vein, it will result in a syndrome known as nutcracker syndrome. And the compression of the third part of the duodenum, it will result in a syndrome known as superior mesenteric artery syndrome. In case of nutcracker syndrome or compression of the left renal vein between the aorta and the superior mesenteric artery, this can lead to renal venous hypertension with the rupture of the thin-walled venules inside the collecting system. This results in hematuria. That's why the usual clinical presentation of the patient is left renal vein and hematuria, either gross hematuria or microscopic hematuria. Regarding the radiographic features of nutcracker syndrome or compression of the left renal vein between the aorta and the superior mesenteric artery, starting with ultrasound features. The proximal left renal vein is grossly distended, as you see in this image. We have marked distension of the proximal left renal vein with at least 8-fold decrease in the diameter of the left renal vein as it passes between the superior mesenteric artery and the aorta, as you see here. Here we can measure what is known as compression ratio. Compression ratio given by the anteroposterior diameter of the pre-compressed vein, this one, divided by that of the compressed vein here in the region of the superior mesenteric artery and the aorta. So the compression ratio is measurement of the pre-compressed vein divided by the diameter of the left renal vein at the region when it passes between the aorta and the superior mesenteric artery, as you see here. The normal compression ratio is less than 2.25. Compression ratio more than 2.25, it's highly sensitive and specific for nutcracker syndrome. Another example, as you see, this is the aorta here. This is the superior mesenteric artery. This is the left renal vein. Here, there is marked dilatation of the left renal vein in comparison to the marked compressed segment of the left renal vein between the superior mesenteric artery and the aorta. And we expect here that if we measure the compression ratio, which is the caliber of the vein here, divided by the caliber here in the area of stenosis, of course, it will be more than 2.25. Coming to the diagnosis of nutcracker syndrome by CT scan, very easy also. Here, this is axial CT for the upper abdomen. This is the left kidney. This is the aorta here, and this is the superior mesenteric artery. This is the proximal left renal vein, which is marked distended in comparison to the marked stenosed or compressed segment of the left renal vein as it passes between the superior mesenteric artery and the aorta. And here also we can measure the compression ratio by measuring the caliber of the proximal dilated renal vein divided by the caliber of the left renal vein at the region of stenosis. And by sagittal CT, very easy to measure the angle between the aorta and the superior mesenteric artery here. Here the angle, it will be less than 22 degrees, and the compression ratio, it will be more than 2.25. If the patient is not complaining and we discover this sign incidentally during the CT abdomen, we shouldn't call it nutcracker syndrome, but we call it nutcracker phenomena or nutcracker anatomy. Coming to the second syndrome, which is superior mesenteric artery syndrome, which is compression of the third part of the duodenum between the aorta and the superior mesenteric artery. the angle become less than 22 degrees, results in compression of the third part of the duodenum with marked proximal dilatation of the duodenum and the stomach also. That's why the patient is usually clinically presented with the signs and symptoms of duodenal obstruction. Regarding the radiographic features of superior mesenteric artery syndrome, starting with fluoroscopy. As you see in this image, upper GI fluoroscopy can demonstrate dilatation of the first and the second part of the duodenum. As you see here, this is the second part of the duodenum and the proximal part of the third part of duodenum. Here we have marked proximal dilatation to the region of the superior mesenteric artery. After that, we have collapsed the small bowel loop distal to the area of the superior mesenteric artery. By CT scan, it's very easy also. As you see, we have marked proximal dilatation of the stomach and the second and the proximal part of third part of the duodenum. And here at the region of the superior mesenteric artery, there is distal collapse of the third part of the duodenum, as you see here. Very easy. In the sagittal reconstruction, we can measure the angle between the aorta and the superior mesenteric artery. It will be less than 22 degrees. As I said in the beginning, we can have either nutcracker syndrome alone when we have compression of the left renal vein, and we may have superior mesenteric artery syndrome alone in cases of compression of the third part of the duodenum. But in some cases, we can have both together. We can have superior mesenteric artery syndrome and we can have nutcracker syndrome in the same patient, as you see in this image. This is CT for the upper abdomen with intravenous contrast. And as you see here, we have marked dilatation of the proximal part of the left renal vein in comparison to marked compressed segment seen when it passes between the superior mesenteric artery and the aorta. This is nutcracker syndrome. At the same time, we have marked dilatation of the stomach and the proximal part of the duodenum, proximal to the region of the third part of the duodenum. Here we have marked compression of the third part of the duodenum as it passes between the superior mesenteric artery and the aorta, as you see here. So this is everything regarding the nutcracker syndrome and the superior mesenteric artery syndrome. See you inshallah in the next episode.